In this video, we will show you China's 13,000 satellite megaproject that shocks the US eye. But who exactly holds the title of global overseer? Beijing, China has recently made a remarkable announcement regarding its space program. Throughout the following 10 years, China focused on putting 100 billion yuan into the send-off of 13,000 satellites. This initiative has been given the codename GW Satellite Program. By and by, upon the arrival of this news, has ignited exuberant discussions among people in general and raised worries inside the worldwide local area. The United States in particular perceives this plan as a potential challenge. Thus, it makes one wonder, what lies underneath the outer layer of China's broad space program, and does it introduce a danger to the US in the space race? The United States has consistently held the top spot globally in terms of satellite count, with its most recent addition being the Starlink satellite initiative. Reports indicate that the United States currently possesses over 2,000 satellites, with the Starlink program contributing a staggering 12,000 satellites to this tally. This expansive satellite network aims to offer global coverage and deliver high-speed internet services to users, thereby fostering digitalization and stimulating economic growth. Despite this, it appears the United States is still unhappy with its current satellite count and is making progress toward a strategy for satellite launch. According to the proposed plan, the United States would launch more than 30,000 extra satellites, bringing its total number of piloted spacecraft to more than 42,000. This will further reinforce their commanding presence within the worldwide satellite industry. The extensive satellite deployment by the United States is expected to exert significant strain on the utilization of resources within the low Earth orbit, causing considerable concerns among the populace. In spite of this, China has established itself as a serious competitor in the aircraft industry, demonstrating its remarkable skills. As per the information gathered in 2019, China sent 38 satellites into space, setting it in the third spot globally, behind just the US and Russia, as far as the number of satellites sent off. The fruitful send-off of the Chang'e 4 test in 2018 is additional proof that China is restless in its obligation to the improvement of satellite innovation. This groundbreaking mission was successful in performing a soft landing and carrying out exploration activities on the unexplored far side of the moon. China, in contrast to the United States, lays more importance on the responsible utilization of resources and the protection of the environment in its satellite activities. One particularly famous example of this is China's Beidou satellite navigation system, which makes use of satellites that were manufactured in China rather than importing satellite technology from other countries. This tactical strategy not only cuts costs, but also increases China's technological independence and operational authority in the area of navigation. On the other hand, it's possible that you're considering a query that's comparable to the one I have. Why have both the United States and China recently begun major preparations for the launch of huge numbers of satellites? It is widely known that there is a limited measure of room accessible in low Earth circles for the sending of satellites. A number near 50,000 has all the earmarks of being as far as possible for the number of satellites that might exist in the low Earth circle, as per ongoing reports. If the United States follows through with its initial launch schedule, it would put around 42,000 satellites into low orbit, which will result in an occupancy rate that is higher than 80% for low orbit resources. As an immediate result of this, it would be challenging for some other nations to utilize these assets. In light of these conditions, every nation on Earth needs to move quickly to grab this window of opportunity. After the US has wrapped up sending off its satellite, there will be no more open doors for different nations to do as such. The Chinese capital city of Beijing has only lately revealed an ambitious satellite plan that would cost 100 billion yuan. Within the next 10 years, the ambitious goal of this groundbreaking initiative is to launch an astounding 13,000 satellites. By taking these steps, China hopes to not only further solidify its leadership in the aviation industry, but also highlight its outstanding technological accomplishments on the international scene. The broad scope of the GW satellite program involves a wide range of uses, some of which are communication, forecasting the weather, and remote sensing. Likewise, a portion of these satellites will be furnished with the most state-of-the-art of man-made reasoning with the end goal of information handling and investigation. As the GW satellite program continues to develop, it is positioned to make significant contributions to China's economic development and scientific advancement while simultaneously igniting a new wave of rivalry in the aerospace sector. As a consequence of this, there is a great deal of interest on a global scale in the launch strategy for China's GW satellite project. However, certain parts of the Indian media have been spreading a different viewpoint, which suggests that the GW satellite effort that China has undertaken is doomed to fail, owing to pessimism surrounding China's capabilities. This position suggests that the Chinese government is hiding something. These claims have caused concern and sparked a need for more investigation, considering the way that China as of now has extensive ability in the field of aviation. The inquiry in question is whether the GW satellite program can be completed actually inside the following decade. China is a crowded country with extraordinary monetary money, and it is extending its endeavors in space research when there is a rising spotlight on the aviation area on an overall scale. The 1950s denoted the start of China's excursion into space, and the nation has since formed into one of just a chosen handful of countries that are able to freely produce rockets and satellites. In addition, it is significant that China has made a significant financial commitment to the aerospace sector. According to information that is readily available to the public, China's expenditures on space exploration were roughly 107 billion yuan in 2019, with those expenditures expected to rise to 120 billion yuan in 2020. Since 2003, China has successfully carried out a number of manned space missions, and in 2019, the country reached a significant new benchmark when it accomplished the first soft landing on the far side of the moon. During the same time period, China's efforts to launch satellites have been significant improvements and developments. One example that is particularly noteworthy is China's successful deployment of 18 Beidou navigation satellites in 2018, which elevated the country's Beidou satellite system to the position of the second largest global navigation satellite system. In addition, the year 2018 saw the launch of two high-resolution remote sensing satellites with the objective of contributing to urban planning and the monitoring of natural resources on land. These events serve as proof of China's solid skills and technological competence in the aerospace sphere. As a result, they encourage increased confidence in the success of China's strategy to launch satellites into orbit. What kind of results can we expect if China is successful in putting its GW satellite program into action? To begin, the establishment of this vast satellite network will make it possible for China to have internet coverage all over the world. This will make the expansion of the Internet of Things, 5G communications, and other related fields much simpler. Second, the satellite network has the potential to be utilized in the development of a worldwide satellite navigation system, which would free China from its dependency on international navigation systems such as GPS. Probably most importantly, this program will move China's aerospace sector ahead, raising the country's position and influence on the world stage. China's GW satellite program has garnered significant global attention and raised concerns within the international community. It has been perceived as a threat by the United States. The reason behind this perception lies in the United States' prominent position in terms of low-orbit Earth satellites. Consequently, China's satellite network could potentially disrupt and influence the functionality of the United States' satellite and communications systems. Additionally, this initiative has sparked competition and imitation among other nations, potentially fueling intense rivalry in the international aerospace domain and exacerbating the issue of space debris. The GW plan in China is an ambitious undertaking that will require perseverance and dedicated labor over the course of a considerable amount of time. We predict that the country will accomplish greater improvements and advancements in satellite technology, thereby providing a strong framework for the effective execution of the GW satellite program. This expectation is based on the continual advancements that China is making in science and technology. Throughout the entirety of this endeavor, we encourage China to embrace an attitude of openness and collaboration, forming partnerships with the scientific and technological community all over the world to foster innovation and growth in satellite technology, thereby making significant contributions to the advancement of human society. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Subscribe.